legendary global investor Jim Rogers is still with us. Hi, Jim. Thanks for sticking around. Jim, got to get your comment on Warren Buffett. You know he's made this massive deal in the last 24 hours, and he says it's an all-in wager on the economic future of the United States. Do you share his all-in wager, Jim?
Well, I don't own any railroad stocks in the United States. In fact, I own virtually no stocks in the United States. I'm more worried about the U.S. than Warren is, apparently. I think the future is more in Asia than in the U.S. But I am an American, I do pay American taxes, and I do have American assets.
But he's definitely betting on the future of the U.S., which maybe you're not doing right now.
Well, it's not that the U.S. is going to disappear and fall into the sea or anything. It's just that relatively, the Asia is growing much more rapidly, and I think there are more opportunities in other parts of the world than there are the U.S. I don't think anybody would deny that the U.S. is a mature economy, you know, the largest debtor in the history of the world. So I think there are better opportunities elsewhere, that's all.
The Fed meets today, we know that, Jim, to decide on rates. No change forecast, but the question being asked by everyone is, when's it going to raise borrowing costs? When's it going to signal a change in policy? What do you think, Jim? What should the Fed be doing right now?
What should the Fed be doing? They should dissolve and go away and leave the market to take care of the situation. The Fed has added gigantic debts of garbage for all the American taxpayers to have to pay off in the next 10, 20, 30 years. The Fed should leave us alone. The Fed basically follows the market, Mark. I don't pay too much attention to the Fed. I mean, I have to because they're making us deeper and deeper in debt. But no, the market sets interest rates. The Fed just follows. They're just bureaucrats, Mark. They don't know any more than you and I do.
But
they
Jim,
may know more than I do, but certainly not more than most people do.
But, Jim, we're still eager to know when they're going to unwind their stimulus, both from a government perspective and a central bank perspective. That's important, is it, when they start to do that and at what sort of pace? What do you think?
Well, there's no question that not just the Fed, the entire U.S. government has taken on gigantic obligations here in the last 2 years, triple, quadruple, quintuple. They don't even know how much they've added to their obligations, and that's going to have to be dealt with down the road. I suspect that in the next year or two, you're going to start seeing more and more problems in the credit markets, the currency markets, and you're going to see all this unwinding, as you put it. The market's going to force an unwinding. It's going to come a time when nobody's left to buy U.S. government bonds.
And Jim, I know that you see more pain in the financial sector. We've had a number of executives, Jim, speaking in the last week, and they've been invoking Christianity to defend the banking system. We've had executives from Goldman Sachs and Lazard International. And last night, Jim, we had the chief executive of Barclays saying, profit is not satanic. Should we be invoking religion, Jim, to defend the banking system?
Well, I think that's going a little bit far. If it's gotten that bad, then we have to rely on religion to save us. In the banking system, things are worse than we figured. Maybe we are going to have more financial crisis than even I expect. You know, even Muhammad, even the prophet, said that making profits is good. I've never heard of any religion saying making profits is bad.
Jim, want to talk about the UK. You said back in January that the UK is finished. We're still in recession. Many countries, as you know, are pulling out of recession. Are we still finished?
Well, what I said was, in context, and it was on Bloomberg, I said was that the City of London, as an income, as a source of balance of trade surplus, is probably not going to be very great in the future, and the North Sea is drying up. So in that sense, the balance of trade surplus that the UK had had for a while is finished, and therefore the currency is going to be in serious trouble, and the UK is going to have problems down the road. You too have added gigantic amounts of debt. It's staggering how much debt the UK and the US have added in the last 2 years.
The pound's had a bad run. Might that run continue, Jim? I mean, has the pound got further to fall? What do you think?
I have no position in sterling, either long or short. I sold all of my sterling a year or two ago, and I have no position. I would expect it to go down over the foreseeable next year or two or three. I just don't see anything that can save the pound sterling coming up, unless you know something that's going to cause a huge surge in UK exports.
Okay.
I don't know what's going to prop up sterling.
Jim, thank you very much for joining us today for all those sections. We'll speak to you again soon. Jim Rogers.